In this video, I will explain how to install a dry ridge system to ventilate the roof space or to ventilate the batten cavity. Starting with roof space ventilation, firstly, lay the underlay over the rafters with a drape and finish it 30mm short of the rafter tops at each side. Fix the tile battens at the required tile gauge, but don't fit the top battens for now. Nail a batten bracket to each rafter top. Once the brackets are in place, the top course tile battens can be fitted. The batten nails can be driven through the ridge batten brackets. Fit the ridge battens. These can be standard tile battens. Fit enough so that the ridge fixing screws can penetrate the ridge battens by at least 45mm. Wrap the batten brackets over the ridge battens and nail into place. Lay the tiles, nailing or clipping, in accordance with the fixing specification. Install the ridge roll. Roll it out along the ridge batten and dress onto the tiles, making sure it is set so that the ridge tiles will sit on its outer edges. Once in position, remove the tape from the adhesive strips and press onto the tiles. Position the ridge tiles centrally over the ridge batten with a ridge union between each ridge tile. Secure each ridge using a screw and a plate. Drill end ridges and secure them with an extra screw at their outer end. This detail shows the arrangement just described. By stopping the underlay short at the ridge, air can move from the roof space out through the dry ridge system. With a ventilated eave system installed, air passing over the ridge will draw air in through the eaves and drive water vapour out at the top. For unvented roof spaces, the dry ridge system should be installed to ventilate the batten cavity as follows. Lay the underlay over the rafters. Finish one side flush with the tops of the rafters, then lap the underlay from the other side over the apex by around 300mm. Fix counter battens over each rafter with a bituminous nail tape fitted between each counter batten and the underlay. Fix the tile battens at the required gauge, but don't fix the top battens for now. Nail a batten bracket to each rafter top, fixing over each counter batten. Once the brackets are in place, the top course tile battens can be fitted. Fit the ridge battens. Fit enough to ensure that the ridge fixing screws can penetrate the ridge battens by at least 45mm. Wrap the batten brackets over and around the ridge battens and nail into place. Lay the tiles and nail or clip them in accordance with the fixing specification. Install the ridge roll. Roll it out along the ridge batten and dress onto the tiles, making sure it is set so that the ridge tiles will sit on its outer edges. Once in position, remove the tape from the adhesive strips and press onto the tiles. Position the ridge tiles centrally over the ridge batten with a ridge union between each ridge tile. Secure each ridge using a screw and a plate. Drill end ridges and secure them with an extra screw at their outer end. This detail shows the arrangement just described. The dry ridge system, in conjunction with a ventilated eave system and counter battens, allows a flow of air from eaves to ridge to drive out excess water vapour from the batten cavity. In summary then, for roofs where the roof space is to be vented, stop the underlay 30mm from the top on each side. For roofs where the roof space is unvented, vent the batten cavity by lapping the underlay over the apex and fit counter battens with nail tape to provide an air path from eave to ridge.